जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, दिस इज धर्मेंद्र मिश्रा वेलकमिंग ऑल इन ज्योग्राफी क्लास। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस सेकेंड लेसन फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज। वेदर द लेसन विल नॉट बी अवेलेबल इन योर बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन बट इन योर पीरियडिक टेस्ट एग्जामिनेशन क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम दिस लेसन विल कम। फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज, टू अंडरस्टैंड द लेसन some of the basic note we need to know, some of the basic terms are there. First term is the natural vegetation. What do you mean by the term natural vegetation? The vegetation which grow naturally in any region without human aid and controlled by the climate of that region are known as natural vegetation. Second term is there forest. What are forests? We obviously discussed that there are degradation of forest, deforestation is going on. So what do you mean by the term forest? It is important to know that. The cluster of trees which grow close to each other over a large area is known as forest. They may contain one species or various species of plants. Third is the term biodiversity. The term biodiversity or the biological diversity includes all forms of life present on the earth, that is plant, animals and microorganisms. The term biodiversity was coined first time by E.O. Wilson. As well as you should know that what are the importance of the forest. Without forest, our earth is barren. They are the ornament for the earth. In this lesson particularly, forest and wildlife resources, we will discuss. In class 9th already, natural vegetation and wildlife we have discussed. In class 10th, the lesson is given to understand as forest and wildlife as a resource and their depletion nowadays and how we can conserve it. Forests are really important for us as they provide timber, soft and hardwood, utilized for making furniture, building materials, etc. They help in attracting rain. They help in rain, they control floods, they conserve soil, they add humus to the soil, they maintain ecological balance. Do you know? In first lesson we have discussed at least 33% of total land area of country should be under forest. At least 33%, one third of total land area of any country should be under forest. In India, forest cover is around 23%, that is so less as per the required. It is required for a better ecological balance. As well as forest also provide livelihood, jivika, livelihood to many people. Many people or tribal community, they are living inside the forest and their life dependent on forest for survival. The lesson is introduced nicely. You can see that here it is given narak. You can see this part. Narak, my lord, you are the creator of music in the world of lepcha. Lepcha is a community, they are living in Sikkim and part of Bhutan. So in India here it is given a Lepcha folk song, given here Lepcha folk song from northern part of West Bengal, Darjeeling as well as Sikkim. In Darjeeling, Lepchas are also found. Narak, my lord, you are the creator of music in the world of Lepchas. It means nature has created music. Oh Narak, my lord, let me dedicate myself to you. We need Lepchas, they are telling that we want to dedicate ourselves to nature. Why? Because nature has created us. Let me gather your music from springs. Where from we got the music? From springs, rivers, mountains, forests, God, from insects and animals. Let me gather your music from sweet breeze and offer it to you. So here it is described or introduced only to understand the importance of forest. Without forest, there will be no life on the earth. We need forests. So here given starting line, I am going to discuss only first. Now see, we share this planet with millions of other living beings, starting from microorganisms and bacteria, lichens to banyan trees, elephants and bluebells. The entire habitat that we live in, immense biodiversity. We humans, along with all living organisms, form a complex web of ecological system in which we are only the part. As we discussed about the ecosystem, what is an ecosystem? It is your distinct zone within the biosphere. It is your distinct zone within the biosphere where all living organisms interact with each other as well as with the physical environment. So we are the part of ecosystem. As a part of ecosystem, it is our duty to save all life forms on the earth surface, because it is the human who have utilized maximum things on earth surface for its benefit and for its development. So the plants, animals and microorganisms which recreate the quality of air we breathe, the water we drink and the soil they produce our food, as I have discussed the importance of forest. Forest play a key role in the ecological system, as I have discussed, at least 1/3 of total land area should be under forest. So these are producers also on which all living beings depend. So given biodiversity, I have discussed biodiversity or the biological diversity means all forms of life present on the earth, including plants, animals and all microorganisms. Flora and fauna in India, two words, flora. Flora means the total vegetation or plant cover of a region, and fauna means the animal life of a given area. So now we are going to discuss about the flora and fauna in India. If you look around, you will be able to find that there are some animals and plants which are unique in your area. In fact, India is one of the world's richest countries in terms of its vast area of biological diversity, biodiversity that is known as, has nearly 8% of total number of species in the world, estimated to be 1.6 million. This is possibly twice or thrice the number yet to be discovered, a number of species we have not discovered till date. So India is a country of biodiversity. We are one of the 12 mega biodiversity rich countries of the world. You may have realized that importance of these resources in our daily life. Yes, this diverse flora and fauna are also well integrated in our daily life. We take these for granted, but lately they are under great stress, mainly due to insensitivity to our environment. We human beings, we are using these resources indiscriminately without thinking that what will happen in future, what will happen to the environment. Because of our insensitivity towards environment, day by day, the environmental degradation is going on. We know that, do you know, of your book it is given over 81,000 species of fauna. But it is now more than 90,000 species of fauna and more than 47,000 species of flora are found in our country. Of the estimated 47,000 plant species, about 15,000 flowering species are endemic. Two words are utilized. Endemic, indigenous to India. It means they are of India. So 15,000 flowering species are endemic. It means they are of India. They are native to India. And many other plants we have taken from other part of the world, called as exporting, E-X-O-T-I-C, exporting. So some estimates suggest that at least 10% of India's recorded wild flora and 20% of its mammals are on the threatened list. As I have discussed, in class 9 we have discussed natural vegetation and wildlife of India. But here we are discussing this forest and wildlife as a resource and its utilization. Because of insensitive use of humans of these resources, what happens? At least 10% of India's recorded wild flora. Wild flora means the flora or the plant found in forest areas, in wilderness, wild, jungle, jisko kehte hain. Jungle is another English word also. And 20% of its mammals are on the threatened list. Many of these would be now categorized as critical, that is at the verge of extinction. You can say at the verge of extinction they are called endangered species. Some of these species will be lost forever, like the Asiatic cheetah from India. Asiatic cheetah no doubt are available there in China and Iran, but from India declared extinct long back ago in 1952. Many of these would now categorize as critical, I told you, called endangered. So there is an urgent need to save not only the wild animals but also the variety of plants which are the base of our life. Our Ayurvedic medicine system is totally based on plant and some of the animal life. We are extracting herbs. Many medicinal plants are there in the forest. It is our duty to save them. In fact, no one can say how many species may have already been lost. How much number of total species you have lost, we don't know. Today we only talk of the larger and more visible animals and plants that they have become extinct. But what about the smaller ones, like insects and plants? So you should know that among the larger animals in India, 79 species of mammals, 44 of birds, 15 of reptiles, and 3 of amphibians are threatened in the verge of extinction. Nearly 1,500 plant species are considered endangered. Flowering plants and vertebrate animals have recently become extinct at the rate of estimated to be 50 to 100 times the average expected natural rate. No doubt, many species have extinct from our surface naturally, but what the rate is there due to unscientific use of these resources, the rate of extinction has estimated more higher than the natural speed, and it is more than 50 to 100 times greater than the natural rate. So in India now forests are also vanishing. Samapt ho rahe hain. You should know that forest and tree cover in the country estimated at 78.92 million hectare, which is about 24% of the total geographical area. And I told you that at least one third, 33% area should be under forest cover. The effort of government of reforestation, afforestation, now the forest cover has raised little bit but not satisfactory. According to the state forest report, this is important part, you must know it. Now see, according to the state forest report 2013, the dense forest covers has increased by 10,098 square kilometer. It means through the policy of afforestation, reforestation, dense forest cover have increased. Since 1997, it's all due to efforts made by people. However, this apparent increase in the forest cover is due to plantation by different agencies. So it's all is not that the natural growth of plantation is given. It's all because of plantation by different agencies, as I have told you. In this lesson, we'll discuss now that different categories of existing plants and animal species as classified by IUCN. IUCN means International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. It is very important term, you must know that IUCN. You can see IUCN, International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, IUCN, they have classified the existing plant and animal species in different 6 categories. It is important to know that what are they. First category is given here, you can see normal species. Normal species, the species which are sufficient in number and have no any threat to their survival, they are considered as normal. Like cattle, cow, buffalo, etc. Salt tree, pine tree, rodents like rats, etc. They are normal. They don't have any threat to their survival. So they are normal species. Second category is endangered species. This word we have discussed already, endangered species. The species which are at the verge of extinction. It means the species would be finished in future if you are not caring about them. The survival of such species is difficult if the negative factors operating against them will continue. Number of examples are quoted in your book. You can see black buck. It is a type of deer. It is found in Rajasthan. The people of Rajasthan, they love nature because they don't have greenery too much. So they try to regreen their areas. They are conserving not only the forest, they are also conserving the wild animals also. Black buck, Kali heron. Crocodile, thinking this that crocodile has no use in our life, so why we have to let them survive, we need to kill them. No, it's not right. All they are, each and every species has a definite role to play in maintaining the balance of ecosystem. In thar desert, we are having camels found in wild. Likewise, Indian wild ass, you can take example of Indian endangered species. Wild ass is found in Great Run of Kutch of Gujarat. Indian rhino, one horned rhino, found especially in Assam and part of West Bengal. Kaziranga National Park is famous for them. There is a big difference between Indian rhino and African rhino. What is the difference? The horn. African rhino has two horn, दो सिंग होता है. Indian rhino is having one horn only. One horned Indian rhinoceros. Long-tailed macaque, it is a type of monkey found in Western Ghat. Sangai, a type of deer in Manipur. All they are now categorized as endangered. It means they are at the verge of extinction. They may be finished in future. Their total number has decreased too much. And if you are not caring them, they will not be available in future. Now, third category is the vulnerable species. The word vulnerable. Vulnerable means subhed. The species which we can caught them, we could caught them easily. These species whose population has declined already to levels from where it is likely to move in endangered category. Endangered in Hindi called sankat grast. So the vulnerable species, they are easy to catch. They are easy to catch them. So what happens? Their number is declining very fast, and in future they may convert into endangered category. Examples of such species are blue sheep. It is a type of sheep found in Himalayan region. Asiatic elephant. Earlier India, lakhs of elephants were present in past, but their number has declined or dwindled a lot, and today they are less in number. We need to save them. Gangetic dolphin. It is a term given here, gangetic dolphin. You can see gangetic dolphin. Locally, in our city, Varanasi, our city is located at the bank of River Ganges. You must know that gangetic dolphin, locally called susuk or susu. Susuk or susu, and some people, local people, also called suis. Gangetic dolphin is found in our River Ganga, but because of unfavorable condition, lot of killing of them, they are also now vulnerable. Next category is rare species. As the name rare, you can understand. The word rare means durlabh. Jo bahut kam milta ho. Naturally, they are very less in number. As given with the small population, naturally they are less in number. They move into the endangered or vulnerable category. They are rare, no doubt they are naturally less in number. If the negative factors operate against them or continue to operate against them, what will happen? They may move into endangered or vulnerable category. The examples of such species are Himalayan brown bear. You can see the examples. Himalayan brown bear, wild Asiatic buffalo. Himalayan brown bear is famous rare species, as well as wild Asiatic buffalo. Jungli bhens. It is very common there in Madhya Pradesh, parts of Assam, but they are very less in number. Desert fox, a type of fox that is found in desert area. You can imagine. And a name is given here. I am highlighting it. You can see hornbill. It is a type of bird in Hindi named as Dhanesh Chidya. Earlier, there were long tall trees were there in past. Sal trees were available. They were so tall, and hornbill built its nest on tall sal trees. But due to deforestation, they lost their habitat. And today they are very less in number. Already naturally they are less, and because of killing of this particular species of bird called hornbill dhanesh, bahut sara shikar iska hua, as well as habitat destruction. Forest kata gaya, iska habitat bhi destruct hua. Because of that, nowadays the species recently has converted as not rare, now it is endangered also. The next category is the endemic species. Endemic species, you can see endemic species. Two words I have discussed. Endemic means indigenous to a particular region. Suppose cotton is a native plant of India. It is originally of India. So cotton is an indigenous or endemic plant of India. Likewise, there are some species, they are found in a certain region, particular areas, usually isolated by natural or geographical barriers. They are not found commonly everywhere. Suppose the examples are given like Andaman teal. It is a type of duck. Ducks are found in India, no doubt, but this type of particular duck is found in Andaman. Andaman and Nicobar pigeon. Another example is given. So this teal and Nicobar pigeon, they are very small in size. They are found only in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. like Andaman wild teak, they are found in Andaman and Nicobar. They are different than the wild teak found in other parts of India. And another example is Mithun. It is a type of animal like yak. Mithun is reared in Arunachal Pradesh. It is endemic to that particular area. It is reared for meat and milk both. At certain occasions, they also utilize meat of it in Arunachal Pradesh. Mostly the Buddhist people they are. So Mithun is endemic to Arunachal Pradesh. And the last category we have to discuss is the extinct species. Extinct species. Now the word extinct you can understand. Samapt. Jo ki species khatam ho chuke. A species can be declared extinct from a region, from entire state, from country, from continent, or from the world. Extinction at any level is possible. These are the species now which are not found after searches of known or likely areas where they may occur. A species may be extinct from local area, I have told you. Suppose a species which is extinct from one area may be found in another area, or region, or country, continent, or the entire earth. Examples of such species are Asiatic cheetah and pink-head duck from India. They have declared extinct. Asiatic cheetah and pink-head duck declared extinct from India, not from world. Even in Asia, in China, Asiatic cheetah is found. In Iran, Asiatic cheetah is found. So, this particular species I am talking about, Asiatic cheetah, declared extinct from India in 1952, long back ago. But here you can understand that extinction can take place at any level, even in local area, in a region, country, or continent, or the entire earth. Right. Now, the next part I am going to discuss about the same species, Asiatic cheetah. Now, see the entire content I am going to discuss. It is a one mark question, important one mark question, not only for your class 10, but also for your future, because in civil services examination it is asked. The world's fastest land mammal. Cheetah is considered as the world's fastest land mammal. They are very commonly found in Africa, in savanna. The cheetah is a unique and specialized member of the cat family, and can move at a speed of 112 km per hour. So, fastest land mammal, no doubt. The distinguishing mark are, but you should know that the cheetahs are generally or oftenly mistaken for a leopard. Leopards are very common. They are found in India. There is a little difference between leopard and cheetah. What is? It is distinguishing mark are the long teardrop shaped lines on each side of the nose from the corner of his eyes to its mouth. Leopards are having same type of shape and size and spotted like the cheetahs, but cheetahs are having line looking like the teardrop. Aansu ki dhar ki tarah line bani rehti hai. That is the distinguishing mark of cheetah and leopard. Prior to 20th century, cheetahs were widely distributed throughout Africa and Asia, even in India. India from ancient time is a rich country for biodiversity. In a Himalayan region, cheetahs were there present in past. But today, the Asian cheetah is nearly extinct due to decline of available habitat and prey. Why the species have lost its existence from India? Two reasons are given here. The two important reasons or causes are, first, the loss or destruction of available habitat. Jungalo ki katai hui. Pedo ki katai hui, loss of forest, it is the loss of habitat for them. And second, lack of animals of prey. Shikar, because these are carnivores and they need some of other animal to eat, so there is lack of animals of prey also. Hiranogara ki kami hume. And the species were declared extinct in India long back in 1952, as I have said for a number of times. Now we'll discuss the next part. What are the negative factors that cause such fearful depletion of flora and fauna from India? We knew that we take various things from forest. We also know that forests are utilized for various purposes. Earlier, forests were known for collecting place for fuel wood and for hunting ground. But today, after as we have converted them into national park, they become the center of tourism also, no doubt. if you look around, you will able to find that how we have transformed nature into a resource obtaining directly and indirectly from the forest and wildlife. We have extracted wood, bark, extracting also leaves, rubber, medicine, dyes, food, fuel, fodder, manure, etc. So it is ourselves who have depleted our forest and wildlife, right? No other creature or animal has depleted our wildlife or forest. It is the human being. The greatest waste inflicted on Indian forest. What are the main causes of depletion of forest in India? First cause I am going to discuss, the greatest damage inflicted on Indian forest was during the colonial period due to expansion of railways for construction of railway lines. They have utilized salt trees to make sleepers. Now sleepers are made up of iron. At that time, lot of sleepers they have made, not only for laying railway line in India, but also to carry all these things to lay railway line there in Europe, in Britain, etc. For extension of agriculture, deforestation occurs. Commercial and scientific forestry. As Britishers had planted pine tree in Himalayan region. Earlier, many plant species were found in that region where today only the pine trees are found. Even after independence, agricultural land extension continues to be one of the major causes of depletion of forest resource. It is believed that it is important to know that between 1951 to 1980, according to the Forest Survey of India, over 26,200 square kilometer of forest area was converted into agricultural land all over the India. It is not good sign. We are expanding agricultural land, we are deforesting the land. It is not good. Substantial parts of tribal belts, especially in northeastern central India, has been deforested or degraded by shifting cultivations. It is known as zone. In shifting cultivation, tribal community, they are generally clearing the patch of forest by burning and cutting trees, and they utilize it for agricultural purposes for 2 or 3 years. Then after they are looking that the soil is losing its fertility, they are leaving the area and doing the same activity in a new area in forest and doing the same work, slash and burn of forest. It is known as jhoom cultivation. It is another region also known as slash and burn agriculture. So jhooming or slash and burn agriculture is also responsible for deforestation in India. Here it is asked, are colonial forest policies to be blamed? Some of our environmental activists say that the promotion of few favored species in many parts of India has been carried through initially termed enrichment plantation. As I have told you, in Himalayan region, Britishers have planted what? Pine trees. And on various plant species we lost because of plantation of only a single type of tree, that is known as pine tree. In central India, they have planted teak in Hindi known as sagon. Because of that, number of plant species they have lost. So these are policies are really, no doubt, they are responsible for this. As given here, teak monoculture has damaged the natural forest in South India, Central India. Cheer or pine tree plantation in Himalayas have replaced the Himalayan oak. Oak is a tree found in Himalaya, and rhododendron forest. It is another type of tree found. And beside this, first we have discussed expansion of agricultural land, laying railway lines, scientific forestry, etc. Jhoom agriculture, these are responsible for degradation of forest or deforestation. Beside that, large scale development project, you can see. Large-scale development projects have also contributed significantly to the loss of forest. Since 1951, over 5,000 square kilometers of forest was cleared for river valley projects. So these are the main reasons. Besides that, mining is another activity. Mining is, you can see here, mining is another important factor behind deforestation. The Buxka Tiger Reserve, BUXA. The Buxka Tiger Reserve located, actually it is located in Assam, in Chirang district, but in book it is mentioned here West Bengal. So we have to go through this. In West Bengal is seriously threatened by the outgoing dolomite mining. Dolomite mining is there because of that the natural habitat of many species and block the migration route of several others including elephant. So what happened due to mining activity, elephants, they are having a natural route to migrate from one place to another place. In rain they are coming to higher ground, in dry season they are coming to lower ground like this. So what happens, the natural route for their migration has disturbed. So mining is another activity for deforestation. Besides that, some of geographers and environmentalists hold the view that greatest degrading factor behind the depletion of forest resources are grazing and fuel load collection also. But grazing and fuel load collection now, it is not too much important factor because in fact, substantial part of fuel fodder demand is made by lopping of tree, lopping means chhatai, rather than felling entire trees. पूरी पेड़ को काटने के बजाय छटाई करके प्राप्त कर लेते हैं. सो इट इज नॉट सो इम्पोर्टेंट रीजन. सो टुडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द रीजंस और द कॉजेस बिहाइंड डिप्लीशन ऑफ फॉरेस्ट इन इंडिया. नेक्स्ट क्लास विल मीट, विल डिस्कस मोर. थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे.